Speaking today on Air Force One, where, again, audio recording was allowed but no cameras, the president took issue with the way he is portrayed as speaking in this new book out next week from Bob Woodward.
The book that was written was fiction. I don't speak that way. I'm highly educated and always did well, and no matter what I did.
How this president talks can be something, as you can tell, he gets sensitive about if he feels someone is calling him out on his intelligence or schooling. Tonight we had a visit to this studio by one of the smartest guys we know. He studies words and the way people say them for a living. And we often ask him about how this president talks other than a lot. So here now, our guest, John McWhorter, armed with a PhD in linguistics from Stanford. These days, he's a professor at Columbia University and a contributor at The Atlantic. Professor, welcome. Is every day in this presidency a word festival in your line of work or Groundhog Day?
Brian, I don't like to watch him. I don't like to listen to him. I like to read my news. And it's bad enough just reading the sorts of things that he says written out when I occasionally am forced to actually watch him do what he does. Then I am just ever struck by what a meat and potatoes approach he has to what most people would approach as statesmanlike oratory.
I think of you constantly because you're the only person in your line of work who I know, and your line of work comes up so often when we watch him. I was watching the president last night in Billings, Montana, and it was his delivery around the subject, by the way, of potential impeachment of himself that struck me. We'll play this and talk to the professor on the other side.
They like to use the impeach word, impeach Trump. Maxine Waters, we will impeach him, but he didn't do anything wrong. It doesn't matter. We will impeach him. We will impeach. But I say, how do you impeach somebody that's doing a great job, that hasn't done anything wrong? Our economy is good. How do you do it? How do you do it? How do you do it? We will impeach him, but he's doing a great job. It's so ridiculous. But worry about that if it ever happens. But if it does happen, it's your fault because you didn't go out to vote.
I say this clinically absent judgment. The man was a reality television entertainment star, headquartered in this building for 14 years. If you look back at Corbett Monica and Buddy Hackett and Shecky Green, the Carson shows
the people
that I think
he grew
you
up
and
watching
I shared
on
generationally,
TV.
That's a set he's doing. That's a set piece. That's borderline stand-up.
Yeah, I mean, what he's doing is the sorts of people that he watched on TV starting in the late 50s and into the early 70s. And really, although, I mean, technically he doesn't drink, he is your uncle sitting by the pool with a beer. That beer is likely a Budweiser. And he's just kind of running his mouth in a colorful way and enjoying the attention of his little nieces and the teenager from next door. But the problem with this is that it shows something more general about him. This goes beyond language. I cannot think of a president in the grand succession we've had who has spent so little effort in trying to be something larger than that swimming pool Budweiser basic. He never tries. So you think of, say, an aristocrat like Franklin D. Roosevelt, who actually forges something like the New Deal. He wasn't thinking about that when he was a kid. John F. Kennedy, you know, to tell the truth, there weren't a lot of things he always had his mind on until he became president, and he was about to do great things. Lyndon B. Johnson was somebody who, frankly, was a very parochial, undereducated, bigoted Texan, and the Great Society comes from him. Donald Trump never does anything that stretches beyond exactly what he was when. And I have this on good authority. This is somebody who took a rather gentle child in his neighborhood when he was a teenager and hung that kid out the window by his feet and enjoyed watching him yell. I have it on good authority. Believe me, as Trump says. He's never gotten beyond being that little nose-picking jerk. He's just exactly what he was when he began. It strikes me that even after almost 2 years, he's never had the slightest impulse to grow. That's what you see in his oratory. He just gets up there and talks. When any other president, I'm sure Zachary Taylor tried to orate, and here we are.
You just said, believe me, that's one of his kind of verbal tics. He does, I'll use his method to make a point. He does repeat the same phraseology in a very short period of time, the likes of which we've never seen before. He does have these fallbacks. We've all come to know them. I know people in my life who say, oh my God, I'm talking like Donald Trump. When you hear yourself using an expression that may come up organically in your life, but it's one that he owns, mm-hmm. it's now a linguistic problem for our country.
You know what it is with him? And this gets into some linguistics. We think of ourselves as using grammar and putting words in it. But there's a modern way of thinking of how language works. You've got your words, you've got things you do with them, like you put an ED at the end to make it in the past. Then you have your expressions, like, what are you doing here? Or believe me, or goodness gracious, or I'll be hornswoggled. Those are words too. So it's really just your big sandbox full of words. It's just that whose is bigger? And what's interesting is that when he uses those same expressions over and over again, what it shows is that he has a small vocabulary, because all of those expressions are words as well. So a certain kind of person has a certain size and can pick and can choose as you get older, especially if you're a relatively, you know, experienced person, say in the public eye, you have kind of a smorgasbord. You try to vary it. But the most inarticulate thing about him is that he uses such a limited vocabulary. And we're not only talking about the sort of Salisbury steak, meat and potatoes. It often sounds like he's only got about 2.5, and it's because he doesn't strive to adorn his speech at all. There's no art in the man. You can't imagine him tapping his foot, reading a book, having a favorite song. And in the same way, with speech, he just lets it all fall out of his mouth like he swallowed some marbles and decided to spit them out one day by the pool with the beer.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.